your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children.
Parkway. So good to see each and every one of you here today, and so glad to have everybody who's joining us via the live stream and via the conference line. So let's all stand together and begin this service with prayer. Father, this is your house. And Father, even more importantly, we are your house. And Father, your Holy Spirit is welcome to fill our temples today and to fill this building today. Oh, Father, we welcome you. And we ask, Father, that you would send the presence and power of your Holy Spirit to move and to manifest and to touch each heart and each life today. Father, we know that you're already here. Your presence is already here. But Father, I pray that you would manifest your presence in a special way, in a mighty way today. Father, gripping our hearts and Father, encouraging us and strengthening us today. And Father, I also pray that, Lord, Jesus would be welcome in this place. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, Jesus said, there I will be in the midst, right in the middle. Oh, Jesus, we just welcome you today. We welcome the Spirit of Christ. We welcome you to just walk up and down these aisles and to touch each heart, touch each life today. But most of all, we want you to get all the glory and all the honor and all the praise today for everything that is said and done. Father, we've set this time apart unto you. And Father, we're privileged and honored today to be able to worship freely in this country. And so, Father, right now in Jesus' name, we set this time aside unto you. And Father, we're gathered together with our brothers and sisters in Christ right now. And Father, it's not about us though, Father. It's all about you. Today is all about you. This time is all about you. So right now in Jesus' name, we just humble ourselves in your presence. And Father, we enter into your gates with thanksgiving. And we enter into your courts with praise. Oh, we lift up a sacrifice of praise to you, the fruit of our lips, giving thanks. Oh, hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this privilege that you've given us today. We don't take it for granted. And Father, when everything is said and done, may we be able to say it has been good to have been in the house of the Lord today. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Let's give God praise. Thank you, Lord.
Sometimes on this journey, I get lost in my mistakes. What looks to me like weakness is a canvas for your strength. And my story isn't over, no, my story's just begun. And failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does. No, failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does. Ooh, lay your burden. Father's house, check your shame at the door, 'cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, you're in the Father's house. Arrival's not the end game, the journey's where you are. You never wanted perfect, you just wanted my heart. And the story isn't over if the story isn't good. And failure's never final if the Father's in the room. No, failure's never final if the Father's in the room. Ooh, lay your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house, check your shame at the door, 'cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, you're in the Father's house. Prodigals come home, the helpless find hope. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room. Prison doors swing wide, the dead come to life. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room. Miracles take place, the cynical find faith. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. father's in the room. Jericho walls are quaking, strongholds now are shaking. Love is breaking through when the father's in the room. Oh, love is breaking through when the father's in the room. Ooh, lay your burden. Cause it ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, you're in the Father's house. Ooh, you're in the Father's house.
Hallelujah. We welcome everyone here at Parkway. We welcome the broken and the hurting. We welcome those that need healing on the inside and healing in their body. We welcome those who are farther along the trail and those that are just beginning their walk with the Lord. We welcome everybody because all of us have a testimony. All of us are in the process of getting closer to God. And so, I don't know about you, but I've got a testimony today. He saved me, He rescued me, He delivered me, He set me free, He healed me, He sanctified me, He filled me with the Holy Spirit, He's making me more and more like Jesus every day. Oh, I'm thankful, even though I'm not what I should be, thank God I'm not what I was. Hallelujah. Do you have a testimony today? Let's go ahead and give Him praise. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Let's thank God for His mercy. Hallelujah.
We've entered into His gates with thanksgiving. Now it's time to praise Him. To praise Him for who He is. To praise Him for all that He's done and all that He's doing and all that He's going to do. He is a good God. Amen. He is a great God. He is an awesome God. He is a merciful God. He is a loving God. Hallelujah. We ought to praise Him, church. We ought to praise Him. Let's just praise Him right now. Hallelujah. We praise You, Lord. We praise You, God. Hallelujah. For who You are and for all that You've done. Hallelujah. Thank You, Lord.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, let all the earth rejoice. He wraps Himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at His voice, and trembles at His voice. How great is our God.
Of the King,
the splendor of the King,
clothed in majesty,
clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice, let all the earth rejoice.
Hallelujah!
He wraps Himself in light,
darkness tries to hide.
Darkness tries to hide, and trembles at His voice, and trembles at His voice. How great is our God.
Oh, come on, church.
Sing with me. How great is our God. And all will see how great, how great.
Time is in His hands.
Time is in His hands.
Beginning and the end. Beginning and the end. The Godhead three in one.
Father, Spirit, Son.
Father, Spirit, Son.
The Lion and the Lamb. The Lion and the Lamb.
How great is our God.
Oh, church, sing with me. How
great is our God.
Hallelujah.
All will see how great.
How great.
How great is our God.
How great is our God. Sing it, church. Hallelujah.
How great is our God.
Worthy of our praise.
Worthy of
above all names. Come on, church, let's sing it to him.
He's the name above all names.
Worthy of our praise.
Worthy of our praise.
Heart will sing.
My heart will sing. How great is our God.
Let's sing it one time, just the voices. How great.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God.
I don't think the Lord is finished with this song yet. Come on, church.
How great is our God. Oh, sing with me, how great
is our God.
And all will see how great,
how great,
how great is our God.
Hallelujah, King of kings, Lord of lords, name above all names.
Name above all.
Let's give him praise, church. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
For there is a move of my spirit that is coming upon the earth. And I am looking for a people who will worship me in spirit and in truth. I am looking for a people that are hungry for me, that are thirsty for me. I am looking for a people that will stand against the opposition that comes against them and persevere and endure and be strong in me. I am looking for a people who will rise up for such a time as this and stand in the gap for my people and for this nation. I am looking for a people, says the Lord. I am looking for a people that will call upon my name. And when you call upon my name, I will answer and show you great and mighty things that you know not of. I am looking for a people this day, and I am looking for you, says the Lord, to rise up and to be part of that holy remnant that is part of the last days church
that holy remnant that will set themselves apart unto me, that holy remnant that will set themselves apart from this world, that holy remnant that will be humble yet bold as a lion, that holy remnant that will rise up in this hour to proclaim my name to all the earth. I am looking for a people, says the Lord. Will you be part of that number? So says the Lord. We believe in the moving of the Holy Spirit. We believe that the Holy Spirit still speaks today. We believe in all of the gifts found in 1 Corinthians 12 and 13 and 14. And all of the gifts, the prophecy gifts, the word of wisdom, word of knowledge, tongues and interpretation of tongues, healings. We believe in all of the gifts. And we believe that the Holy Spirit still speaks today. If you believe that this was a word for you or for our congregation, would you just raise your hand and just testify? Amen. 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 Can we just answer that call right now? Right where we are. Can we just answer that call? God is looking for a people. He is looking for a people. Can we just respond to Him? Right where we are, even those who are watching and listening remotely, let's just respond to the Lord right now and present ourselves to Him right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we present our bodies as living sacrifices. Oh God, let us be holy and acceptable and pleasing to You, which is our reasonable service, which is our spiritual act of worship. Oh God, we just deny ourselves today and take up our crosses and follow after Jesus. Oh, let us be crucified together with Christ, and let us no longer live, but Christ live in us. And the lives we now live, let us live by the faith of the Son of God, the one who loved us and the one who gave Himself up for us. Oh God, let Your Holy Spirit find us today. Let us be found faithful in Your word, faithful in prayer, faithful in Your Spirit. Oh, let us be found faithful today. Oh God, we humble ourselves before You. We pray, we seek Your face, we turn from our wicked ways. Oh God, hear from heaven and forgive our sin and heal our land today. Oh God, we're standing in the gap for our own families. We're standing in the gap for our own congregation. We're standing in the gap for our own nation today. We're standing in the gap today. Oh God, oh God. We need You. We need You, Lord. We recognize our need for You like never before. We need You, oh God. Oh God, we want to just say right now, have Your way in us. Have Your way in us. Have Your way in this church. Have Your way in this nation. Oh, we thank You, God, that You are still God. Hallelujah. That You are still enthroned in the heavens. Hallelujah. That Your throne is not shaken by the circumstances of this earth or the things that surround us right now. Hallelujah. Oh, thank You, God, that You have a plan. Hallelujah. And that You are going to see that plan through to completion. Oh, hallelujah. So, Father, we want to be found faithful today. As Your people, we repent of our sins, the sins of our ancestors, the sins of our family, the sins of our church, the sins of our city and county and state and nation. We repent. We repent in Jesus' name. We repent and we ask that You would cleanse us and wash us, purify us and sanctify us. Fill us with Your Holy Spirit. Make us like Jesus. Anoint us and empower us and enable us. as your sons and daughters, to be your servants and your witnesses, to be your salt and light, to be your prophets and priests and kings and holy martyrs if necessary. Oh God, send us out into this world for your glory and for your honor, I pray. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Can we give God praise this morning? Thank you, Father. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He saw my kai. I like holy, 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 holy.
Let there be an interpretation. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. 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 Let's just respond to the Lord right now. He's calling us close to Him, His side. He's calling us into His holiness. And our tendency is to jump back in fear when we see the holiness of God.
But God does not call us to anything that He does not also equip us for. And so as He calls us into His holiness, He also equips us with the holiness of Christ, with the righteousness of Christ. Let us respond to His holiness today. Let us respond to His call to draw near to Him. Oh God, we draw near to You. Oh God, we are cognizant of the fact that You are holy. You are holy. And in ourselves, we're so unholy. But in Christ, You have made us holy. Oh, thank You, Father. Thank You for that shed blood on Calvary that has made us holy. Now help us to walk in that holiness that You have provided for us. Oh God, we recognize that You are God and we are not. Oh God, You are holy. You are holy. Holy, holy, holy. Lord God Almighty, who was and who is and who is to come. Kadosh, 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 Yahweh Sebaoth, the whole earth is full of Your glory. You are holy, 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 holy. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. Can we stretch our hands toward heaven and sing that again? Hallelujah.
How great is our God.
Holy, holy.
Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God.
How great is our God. How great is our God.
How great is our God. Sing with me,
how great
is our God. And all will see how great is our God.
Name above all names, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Father, we just pray and intercede right now for the body. For the body of Christ, we lift up Corky North, who's still in the hospital at UT. In Jesus' name, we pray that you would raise him up and send him home with health and wholeness and healing in his body. Oh God, we pray in Jesus' name for Donna Husky. We pray, Lord, for all of those, Christine Williams and all of those right now who are struggling with sickness or disease. Father, we pray right now that they would receive that healing in their bodies that they that has already been provided for them through the finished work at Calvary, through Jesus, by whose stripes we were healed. In Jesus' name, we pray for healing for the body. Father, we just lift up Buddy Williams and his entire family. Father, let's just stretch our hands towards Buddy on the back row, and let's just lift up his entire family. Father, as he's buried his father today or this week, Father, we just lift up Buddy and his entire family right now. And Father, we just pray for the comfort of your Holy Spirit to surround them and lift them up and encourage them, strengthen them, be with them, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. If you've got a need, just raise your hand and let's just agree with one another on behalf of our own needs. Father, we just lift up our needs and the needs of our congregation right now, the needs of all those who are listening and watching right now remotely. In Jesus' name, we lift up every need. And Father, we just ask largely of you today. Thank you, Father, that you have adopted us into your royal family. You've made us heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. You've invited us into the very holy of holies and, Father, to the throne of grace to obtain mercy, to obtain help in our time of need. And, Father, we are a needy people today, but, Father, we thank you that you are a big God. Hallelujah. There is nothing that is too hard for you. There is nothing that is too difficult for you. So, Father, we lift up every need that is amongst us right now in Jesus' name. And, Father, we're asking largely of you. We're asking for salvations and deliverances and healings. We're asking for provisions in Jesus' name. Oh, God, you are able. And, Father, as we ask largely of you, we thank you, God, that you have told us to ask and to believe and to receive. So, Father, we just go ahead and believe and receive the answer to our prayers in Jesus' name. Your word says, my God shall supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. So right now in Christ Jesus, we receive the answer to our prayers in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Now let's praise him, church. Let's praise him together. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you for hearing and answering our prayers. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let's rejoice in this word of encouragement today. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wow. Hallelujah. I'm so grateful for the presence of God today. Amen. Amen. You may be seated, those that haven't already been seated. God bless you. Let's just continue in this attitude of worship and praise to God. Amen. We're so blessed to have everyone who is joining us remotely. And let's go ahead and welcome all those who are joining us remotely. It's so good to have everyone joining us via live stream and via the conference line. We welcome you today. I'm Pastor Philip Morris, And this is my wife, Denise, and we're so honored to be the pastors here at Parkway, and we're so delighted to have everyone who's joining us remotely and everyone who's here in person especially. It's so good to see all of you today. And if this is your very first time with us, I sure would like to get to meet you after the service. I plan on being out in the lobby area and outside maybe. So I don't want to encourage anybody to congregate in the lobby because we're, you know, still under COVID advisory. But I sure would like to get meet you today and get to know who you are. So you're welcome. Parkway, let's welcome all of our first-timers today. Amen. Amen. This week is a special week. As you know, tomorrow is the Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. holiday. And normally here in Sevierville, we have a big celebration at First Baptist on each of these holidays. But due to COVID, that event has been canceled this year. But it's going to be broadcast. Last year's event is going to be broadcast live on television during this time tomorrow. I can't remember exactly what times, but you can tune in and catch last year's celebration tomorrow. And also, Jamesina and Aaron Miller left newspaper inserts out in the lobby if you want to pick one up on the way out, and that details all of the information on the celebration of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Wednesday nights, we are having a wonderful time, even though we're still remote in our Bible study, 6:30 p.m., we are studying the book of Exodus. And last week, we had a great time exploring how the Egyptians placed the Israelites in bondage. And this week we're going to turn to the second chapter, and Brother Joe's going to teach this week on when Moses was born. It's an exciting study, one of my favorite books of the Bible. So I encourage you to join us remotely, either via Facebook Live or YouTube Live or via the conference line, and you'll really enjoy this study. I'm trying to remember if there's something else that I need to mention. Okay. Well, let's just dive into the Word of God. Is that all right? Okay, two of you said yes. Let me try it one more time. Let's dive into the Word of God. Amen? Amen. We are in the middle of 21 days of prayer and fasting. And as I thought about what I needed to share or what I should share this Sunday, I felt drawn back to the book of Daniel. Because Daniel, in chapter 10 through 12, Daniel had his own 21 days. He had 21 days of seeking the Lord. He had 21 days of humbling himself before the Lord. And wow, what an incredible revelation came to him either during that time or shortly thereafter. So I felt like I should go ahead and just dive into Daniel chapter 10 today. So if you have your Bibles or if you have your electronic devices and you want to follow along, Daniel chapter 10, beginning with verse 1. In the third year of Cyrus, king of Persia, a word was revealed to Daniel, who was called Belteshazzar. Now you will remember the backstory, those of you that have studied the book of Daniel. The backstory is that Daniel was taken from his homeland when he was a very young lad. And he was taken from Israel, the land of Israel, to Babylon. And in Babylon, he became part of the king's court. And he received a Babylonian name, Belteshazzar. You see, the problem is, though, that Belteshazzar is the name of a foreign god, Bel. And so Babylon was always trying to fit Daniel into a Babylonian mode, a Babylonian pattern, a Babylonian system. But Daniel stood strong, and he stood up for what he believed in, and he never compromised his faith. And so now the time of the Babylonians is over. And now the Medes and the Persians have taken over the kingdom of Babylon. And you will remember that it was the Medes and the Persians that threw Daniel into the den of lions. And there Daniel faced what perhaps was his supreme test. Was he going to trust God? And he did trust God. And the Lord delivered him from the lion's den. Hallelujah. And the next morning the king said, Daniel, are you still alive? And Daniel said, long live the king. Yes, I am. I'm still here. And I'm still alive for the kingdom of God. So let me just encourage you. Always remember that you are just an alien and a stranger who is just passing through. You are just an alien and stranger. You don't need to get too attached to the things of this world. You don't need to get too attached to relationships and possessions. You don't need to get too attached, because we are just passing through. Hallelujah. The kingdom of heaven is one day going to take over the earth. And hallelujah, the kingdoms of this earth will become the kingdoms of our Lord and of His Christ. And He and we will reign forever and forever. So we're just passing through. Hallelujah. So we don't need to let the world force us into its mold. We don't need to let the world force us into its patterns. We don't even need to let the world force us into its politics. Hallelujah. Got one or two amens on that one. We don't need to be conformed to this world, but we need to be transformed by the renewing of our minds. Hallelujah. We need to be steadfast, standing for our faith. And then verse 1 continues. This word that was revealed to Daniel, and the word was true and a great conflict. And he understood the word, and understood, and understanding was given to him in the vision. Now, that's unusual language. The word was true and a great conflict. Well, what does that mean, Pastor? Well, those of you that have read ahead and you know what's coming in this vision that Daniel had in chapter 10, 11, and 12, it talks about wars and all kinds of upheaval in the earth. So is it just talking about the vision being about a great conflict? Is it just talking about the vision being about wars? I don't think so. I think that the word itself caused Daniel conflict. Why is that? Because the word, look at this, verse 1. The word was true. And every time the Lord reveals His true word, something else also gets revealed. It also reveals where we are not basing our lives on the truth. It also reveals where we have been untrue.
And so as Isaiah saw the Lord high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple in Isaiah chapter 6, Isaiah said, "Woe is me, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, Yahweh Sabaoth, the Lord of hosts." When the true word of God comes, it reveals what is also untrue. And the Spirit of God, the sword of the Spirit, you understand that it divides asunder to the bone and the marrow, the soul and the spirit. The truth of God's word, if it does not cause a conflict in you, then maybe you haven't been listening to the true word. I'll let that sink in for just a minute. Let's move on to verse 2. "In those days, I, Daniel, was mourning for 3 weeks, 21 days. He was mourning. Well, why was he mourning? Had somebody died? No. He was mourning. You know, when we finally get discontented with the status quo, we will also mourn like Daniel. Daniel was not satisfied with the status quo. What was the status quo? The status quo was his people were still captive in Babylon. And his people were going to be released by Cyrus, king of Persia, to go back to the land of Israel. And Daniel was mourning. But I think it was more than just about his people. I think Daniel was mourning because his own status quo was making himself miserable. How many of you know, when you start getting closer to God, you often become more miserable? How many of you know that your own status quo can sometimes make you discontented? You hunger for God. You thirst for God. And you find yourself empty of the things that you want to be full of. Oh, church, I believe God is looking for a church this morning. I believe God is looking for a church in this hour that is discontented, has a holy discontent with the status quo. The holy discontent with the status quo of our personal lives. A holy discontent with the status quo of the church in America right now. A holy discontent with the status quo of where our nation is going. Oh, church, how can we love God and love others and not be discontented with the status quo that we see all around us? We should be mourning. We should be grieving over our sin, over the sins of our families, over the sins of our nation. We should be discontented with the status quo. And so verse 3, Daniel did not eat desirable food. Meat and wine did not come to my mouth, and I did not anoint myself at all. In other words, Daniel figured that in order for the status quo to change, he couldn't keep performing the status quo. In other words, Daniel realized that if he was hungry for change, that change needed to begin in him. Oh, hallelujah. I believe God is looking for a church who is hungry for change, a church who is hungry to be found in Him. I believe that God is looking for a church who's willing to push aside the plate, who's willing to push aside possessions, who's willing to push aside even relationships that are binding us and holding us back. I believe that God is looking for a people who are hungry and thirsty for Him and not just hungry and thirsty for food. Amen. Let's give Him praise. Amen. Amen. Verse 4, and on the 24th day of the first month, as I was by the side of the great river, which is the Tigris. Now let me point out, on the 24th day of the first month, Daniel had been setting aside his 3 weeks, his 21 days, in the first month of the year. Now I'm not going to say that's just like what we're doing, because our calendar year is a little different than the Jewish calendar year. The biblical Jewish calendar year starts about March 14th this year with the month of Nisan. But that was also the same timing for the calendar of the Medes and Persians. But let me just point out that the first of the year is a good time to set ourselves apart for what God wants to do in the coming year. I believe that God wants to supercharge and set His church on fire for this coming year. But how will we be ready for that if we don't set ourselves apart unto Him at the first of the year? And then verse 5 begins Daniel's vision. I lifted my eyes and looked, and behold, a certain man clothed in linen, whose waist was girded with gold of Uphaz. His body was like beryl, his face like the appearance of lightning, his eyes like torches of fire, his arms and feet like burnished bronze in color, and the sound of his words like the voice of a multitude. Wow. This is very similar to the appearance of Jesus to John in Revelation chapter 1. And there may be some that would argue with me, but I believe that Daniel had a vision of Jesus. Daniel had a vision of the pre-incarnate Jesus. I believe that. And when he had this vision, it wasn't just Jesus showing up to say, pat him on the back and say, oh, everything's going to be all right. It was him catching a glimpse of the glorified Jesus. Church, I'm not going to tell you that you're going to have a vision of Jesus if you set yourselves apart unto Him for 21 days. And if you haven't started this 21-day journey with us, hey, you can join in at any time. We're just asking people to give up something for 21 days in order to get something, and that something is Jesus, and to get closer to the Lord. So I'm not telling you that you're going to have a supernatural experience if you set yourselves apart for 21 days. But what I am telling you is what the book of James says. Draw near to Him, and He will draw near to you. He has promised that if we seek His face, then He will draw near to us. Hallelujah. So Daniel, in my opinion, catches a glimpse of Jesus. Verse 7, and I, Daniel, alone saw the vision, for the men who were with me did not see the vision. But a great terror fell upon them, so that they fled to hide themselves. So Daniel is the only one who saw the vision.
Let me just tell you something, church. Nobody can take your place in terms of you getting closer to Jesus. Your pastor can't get you closer to Jesus. Some of you may be shocked at that. Hey, there isn't anybody who can get you close to Jesus but you. Not your mother, not your father, not your kids, not your brother, not your sister. Now, they can help along the way, but what it boils down to, though none go with me, still I will follow Jesus. We have to have a made-up mind. We have to have a mind that it won't waver to the left or waver to the right, but a face set like flint. And we've got to make up our mind to get closer to Jesus. Oh, how many of y'all remember the old terminology, praying through? Nobody can pray through for you but you. You have to make up your mind that you are going to get a hold of God and not let go until the answer comes. Amen. So nobody can go to God but you for you. Verse 8, therefore I was left alone when I saw this great vision, and no strength remained in me, for my vigor was turned to frailty in me, and I retained no strength. Well, wait a minute, Pastor. I thought the Lord only showed up to encourage us and make us feel good. It doesn't sound like Daniel was feeling real good right now. All his strength was gone. It's kind of like in the book of Revelation, verse chapter 1, John said that when he saw the Lord, he fell as though dead. Let me just encourage you. Before you can come alive in Christ, you first must die in Christ. I have been crucified together with Christ, Galatians 2:20. Nevertheless, I live, but not I, but Christ lives in me. And what life I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, the one loving me and the one giving himself up for me. So you first got to die before you can live in Christ. Amen. Jesus said, deny yourselves and take up your cross daily and follow me. So Daniel was robbed of all of his strength. I want to just mention to you this morning that many of us seem to rely on our own strength instead of relying on the strength of the Lord. Many of us seem to rely on our own intellect or rely on our own physical bodies and our own physical strength. And you know, don't get me wrong, exercise is good and all that is good. But all of that pales in comparison to knowing Jesus. And you cannot rely on your natural strength and know the realm of the supernatural. We must first empty ourselves of the natural in order to be filled with the supernatural. We must first empty ourselves of all of the works of the flesh and the lust of the eye and the pride of life. We must first empty ourselves in order to be filled up with Him. So don't be surprised if when Jesus shows up, you start getting empty. Why does that happen? Because He wants to fill you up, and He can't fill you up if you're full of other stuff. I'm going to move along. Yet I heard, verse 9, the sound of His words. And while I heard the sound of His words, I was in a deep sleep on my face.
with my face to the ground. Church, I feel compelled to tell us all this morning. Jesus is not coming back for a slumbering church. Jesus is not coming back for a church that is asleep. Jesus is issuing a wake-up call. And I believe that wake-up call is going out over all the earth in our time. He is calling for the church to wake up. To wake up. To wake up. Oh, hear the trumpet sound of His voice. Hear the call and the cry of His heart. Oh, church, we've been asleep on our watch. Oh, church, we've supposed to been the watchman on the walls, but we've been asleep on our watch. But Jesus is coming, hallelujah, and He's waking us up, hallelujah, by the fiery presence of His Holy Spirit. He is setting a fire, setting a flame to His church, and He is calling us to wake up, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse 10, suddenly a hand touched me, which made me tremble on my knees and on the palms of my hands. What is the first thing that happens when the church awakens? It needs to get on its knees and on the palms of our hands. We need to be a praying church. We need to be on our knees. We need to be crying out to God. That is the first and primary calling of each and every one of us. Oh, I know many of us have the gift of singing and the gift of playing instruments and the gift of serving and the gift of teaching, and that's all wonderful. But let me talk to you for just a moment about what Jesus cares about in a primary way before He cares about any of those other gifts. Jesus wants us to have a white, hot, fiery, passionate relationship with Him. And how can that happen unless we pray, unless we call upon His name, unless we listen to His voice? Oh, church, first of all, we must be a people of prayer. Amen. Let's continue. Verse 11, and He said to me, O Daniel, man greatly beloved, understand the words that I speak to you, and stand upright, for I have now been sent to you. While He was speaking this word to me, I stood trembling. Oh, church, that is the next step. Once we become a praying church, then we need to rise up. To rise up. To stand clothed in the whole armor of God. To stand against the devil's schemes. To stand. He's looking for a church that will stand in the face of adversity, that will stand in the face of situations and circumstances that seem to be surrounding us. Oh, church, He needs a church that is willing to stand. Hallelujah. This age that we live in, this nation that we live in, does not need a wimpy, backboneless church. This nation that we live in needs a nation of men and women who are willing to stand their ground in the kingdom, to stand their ground in the spirit, to stand their ground in prayer, back to back, shoulder to shoulder, side to side. Oh, hallelujah! Will we stand and be the church in this hour? Hallelujah. I'm going to ask us to stand right now. I'm not done yet, but I'm going to ask us to stand. If you are willing to be the church, if you are willing to be the church in this hour, let's stand together And let's lift up a mighty war cry to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah! Yes! 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 Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Yes! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Thank you, Lord. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah! 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 Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah. Church, I'm not done, but I feel like I'm supposed to bring this thing to a different ending than I was planning. I believe that God is calling us in this hour, in this moment, to empty ourselves. To empty ourselves of all that is consuming us. To empty ourselves of all of our desires and our wants, all of our agendas, to empty ourselves of all of the possessions and relationships that seem to consume us, to empty ourselves of all of the stuff that we've been putting in our eyes and putting in our ears, all of the broadcasts and all of the different things that have been coming across the TV set. I feel like we're supposed to empty ourselves today. Oh, hallelujah. And return to being a church of prayer. In these 21 days of prayer, I'm praying in Jesus' name that a fire would be lit. A fire would be lit inside of me. A fire would be lit inside of you. A fire would be lit inside of us, the church. That a fire would be lit inside of us. And that we would once again become a praying church. A church that stands in the gap for our families, that stands in the gap for our church, that stands in the gap for our nation. Church, God is calling us to prayer. God is calling us to intimacy with Him. God is calling us to have a radical encounter with the living God. And then I believe that God is calling us to stand. To stand up. Where has the church been? Church, arise in Jesus' name. Arise from our sleep. Arise from our slumber. Arise and stand. Stand firm, having done all to stand. Clothed in the whole armor of God, put on the whole armor of God and stand against the devil's schemes. The devil has run rampant over our families and over our churches and over our nation. We need to stand against the powers of darkness. We need to stand. Our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, rulers of darkness, spiritual wickedness in the heavenlies. Our Our plan does not need to include personal attacks on anyone. Our plan needs to be to get in our prayer closets until we're set on fire by the Holy Spirit of God, and then come out to wage warfare on behalf of the body of Christ, not in flesh and blood battles, but to stand against the devil's schemes. Oh, church, I'm believing that God is calling us today to stand up for such a time as this. For such a time as this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So the question is, who will be part of the Lord's army? Who will be part of the Lord's army? When Gideon tried to gather an army, God said he needed to send away all those who were fearful and frightened. Who will stand in the gap? Who will receive from the Lord the strength, the supernatural strength, the supernatural courage to stand up for such a time as this? Hallelujah. I hear the words of Joshua, the words of the Lord to Joshua. Be strong and courageous. Be strong and courageous. Oh, let me say it again. Be strong and courageous. You cannot fight these battles in your own strength. Oh, it's only by Him, hallelujah, that you have the victory. Not by might nor by power, but by His Spirit, says the Lord of hosts. So be clothed in the whole armor of God and stand up. Stand up. I know there's a pandemic going on. Stand up anyway. I know that our nation is experiencing lawlessness. Stand up anyway. I know that many of us are facing personal struggles and the loss of jobs and you name it on down the list. Stand up anyway. Stand up anyway. Oh, listen, church. I believe that God is calling us aside during these 21 days so that we can be His army that goes out to battle this year and establishes His kingdom on the earth. So who will be a part of that army? When Isaiah saw the Lord high and lifted up, he overheard the Lord. Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? And Isaiah's answer was, here am I. Send me. Oh God, I may be standing trembling, but by your grace, I'm still standing. Anoint me and empower me with your strength, with your power, to be part of this last day's army. In Jesus' name. I know that you just need to respond from your own hearts, but let me just ask for those of us that want to make a public response, because I believe that we're going to look back to this day and we're going to say, this was the day that the Lord called us closer to Him. I'm going to ask us to just give a public response. Who will stand and be part of the Lord's army? Can you raise your hand? Hallelujah. Oh, Pastor, what can God do with so few people? Oh, He can do mighty things. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst. And where two or three agree concerning anything, it shall be done. If one can put 1,000 to flight, then two can put 10,000 to flight. Oh, hallelujah. God can use the things that are small to do mighty things. Oh, Pastor, what can we possibly do for the kingdom of God? Oh, just ask Gideon's army, his small little army that went out and defeated the great army. Oh, God can do anything if he can find somebody who's willing. Hallelujah. He can do anything. Hallelujah. So let's just dedicate ourselves to him right now in Jesus' name. Father, we are presenting ourselves, our bodies as living sacrifices. We don't come in our own strength, but we are completely and utterly dependent upon you. And Father, we can't do anything worthwhile apart from you, but we can do all things through Christ who gives us the strength. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So will you just take this army of willing volunteers. Oh, these people today who have raised their hands and said, I am willing to be counted in the Lord's army in these last days. Take this band of willing volunteers and mold us and shape us and renew us and revive us and transform us so that we can be the people of God for such a time as this. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God of Israel, let it be so. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give God praise again. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege of being called into your service. So now, as we're getting ready to leave, let me just urge you to give up something during this 21 days. And when you give up that something, don't forget that you need to seek something else to fill its place. And that something else is a someone. It's Jesus. Seek his face. Hunger and thirst for him. And by God's grace, he will light a fire in us for his glory and for his honor. God bless you, Parkway. I love you all so much. God bless all of you who have been tuning in remotely. I love you. God bless you. Have a great, wonderful, blessed day, the rest of your day, and a wonderful week this week. Don't forget our Wednesday night Bible study remotely at 6:30 p.m. I love you. Shalom.
I can do anything, I can do all things, cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible, through you, my eyes are open, strongholds.